So this is Be Quiet's Silent Base 802. We just did the review on that and we still need a couple of B-rolls, so I will need to use it inside of a build. And I want to use this build to test a few different things. First of all, what are we going to use? As usual, still A12-900K. It has still not been used inside my own build, so it is still available. But now we will try to cool it using Be Quiet's own Shadow Rock 3, which is very convenient because that way I can A, find out if I can really use the Shadow Rock 3 on top of a CPU as hot as a 12900K, plus because this is one of the only LGA 1700 mountings that I own, I can finally use my ASRock B660 Steel Legend. I already wanted to use it in another video, but there I realized last moment that the Gilead Glacier RGB did not have the LGA 1700 mounting, so I had to backtrack to another motherboard. This time, however, I can do it. Now, just as last time, I do know this is a B660 board, this is a 12900K, this is a very bad idea, but at the same time, I will be able to verify, because we will use a hardware that has been used with a Z690 board, and I can verify if there is any performance difference between using a stock Z690 board or a stock B660 board, but because I think it's interesting. Because I don't believe that many people will do like any overclock at all. And this way I can see if the board does something or if anything works better, and you know, if there is some sort of improvement for going for the mainstream lineup. Then we will go with the Crucial Ballistics. It's a 32 gig kit. No, it's a 16 gig kit of 3200 memory. DDR4, of course, because this is a DDR4 board. And I'm using this because I've been using this in the other builds where we had the 1200K. In combination with our beloved Gigabyte RTX 3070 Vision. As the last few components, the Samsung SSD that I have all the games on, because I need that. Then we have a Be Quiet power supply that they sent over last month. Again, thank you for that. And we will also use this brand new pack of... Yes. This brand new pack of BitPhoenix cable extensions. Now, we've used the black ones before. And they look good. I like how they look, but especially I like the fact that the aluminum combs on there are separating the cables into like four cable groups, like cable groups of four. And I think that looks really, really good. And I think you can see the color scheme here. I mean, everything is white with the, and that's kind of cool because we have like the bottom white part of the GPU, and the top is like a aluminum thing, like metal thing. The same thing we have on the motherboard. We have white pieces and we have like the aluminum parts, and then we have the Be Quiet Shadow Rock 3, which is again aluminum, and the only part the only problem is the black top. However, we have the black fans in there, so everything, like, it makes sense. Everything here makes freaking sense. Additionally, I will be able to, you know, test a bit the temps inside of this puppy, experiment with the anti-noise port and with the mesh port to get more airflow. This will be kind of fun, and we will see how far we can push this. So yeah, let's start. This episode is brought to you by Strummers and their beautiful collection of FPS increasing mouse pads. You can either choose one of their pre-created designs or go ahead and build your own using their customizer, which allows you to see what it would look like if your room wasn't such a mess. But what sets Strummers apart? Custom stitching colors, washable, 3mm thickness, ultra sticky bottom, sizes ranging from small to a carpet, and the most beautiful unboxing experience you could wish for. Not convinced yet? Let's do a quick review. Screw test. Passed. Screwdriver test. Passed. Case test. Pest. Learn more about Strummers and their mouse pads by using the links in the description below. forgot to put in the cooler. I forgot to put in the cooler. Instead of taking out the main board and then putting in the cooler from outside, like any sane person would do, what we will do is test how well the case can be used to, you know, do this kind of stuff after the fact of putting the main board in. I just removed the M.2 bracket in the back, which means that now we have complete access to the holes around the CPUs, which means that putting in the cooler after the fact or replacing the cooler inside of a be quiet silent phase is just as easy as doing it outside of a case. Okay, now putting on the most horrifying part, the bridge. Who at Be Quiet still thinks this is a good idea? Especially doing it like this after the actual fact. Come on. Well, that was much less horrific of an experience than I actually expected. It's, and I think that's due solely to how the case can handle that. I think that's all, yeah, they did a pretty good job at this one. No! It doesn't reach. Damn it! So what I will also do is connect the CPU fan to the controller in the back and connect the controller to the CPU out on the to the CPU fan out on the motherboard. And the reason I'm doing this is because I wanted to do some like thermal testing using that controller. Okay, so that's a point of improvement. Give this like 5 centimeters more to be able to reach that damn CPU header. That's really dumb. I don't remember what the question was, but the answer is a definite yes. So a few things. First of all, I have no idea why, but I get the feeling that cable managing the white Bitphoenix cables is for some freaking reason more complicated than doing it with the black ones. Like, I feel like the white ones are way more like flexy, muddy, you know, I had a hard time aligning them like they are aligned now, whereas on the black one, I did not have that. Then, cable managing inside of a silent base is basically just stuff the cables in, plus I think it's a really good use to use like those bracket holders to stuff the cables in, and it's not... I know it's not like the prettiest, but it has a purpose because there will be like a second video where I need the plate, the space in the bottom. But we will talk about that at the end of the video. For now, I did not install any additional fans. You might now say, well, I have a 12900K, why the hell am I doing this? And this also has a freaking purpose. Because I wanted to try out if the case, as a standalone, can do this. Plus, the Shadow Rock is like the mid-tier line, so I am putting a lot of force on that thing. But we will see how it handles it, and we will see how the P-Wings 2 that are included in the case will handle the job. But okay, I think with that out of the way, it should be time to do some thermal testing. between me saying let's quickly benchmark or thermal test this and now are something like 3 or 4 hours. It was a nightmare. Let's start off with the thing that you probably saw during the B-roll section, with the two RAM sticks being nicely attached to each other. The story behind that one, yes, I know it is wrong, I did it on purpose. The reason is the RAM slot A2 is dead. I was not able to get any stick of RAM running in it, not even a single one. I tried my Trident Z's, I tried the G-Skill Aegis that I have, I tried every combination, and nothing worked. It is dead. Also, very interestingly, I think slot A1 is also dead, because if I try to do dual channel mode in the other two, it still doesn't work. It was a horrible experience to find this out. I even did things like BIOS update, and here and there, it is not working. A1, A2, probably both are dead. I had to do it this way. Now, this doesn't create any particular issue, it's just that the RAM slots are not running in dual channel mode, which is detrimental to performance, which is another topic that would be very interesting here. I had to do it, I'm sorry, I know everybody's getting an aneurysm because of this right now, but now it looks like a pre-build. Okay, that being said, I did a lot of thermal testing. I originally did it with the anti-noise panel with the acoustic foam inside. And I did it with the airflow panel that we have now in the front. The first big question about this video was if the Be Quiet Shadow Rock 3 is able to cool down a 12900K. The answer is yes, but don't do it. Hitting the CPU with CPU-Z bench test, or the stress test, sorry, we hit between 94 and 96 degrees C on the package. That is too much. That's the upper limit that you can hit before a thermal throttle, so don't do it. Then we replaced the panels with the airflow meshy-like ones, and the temperature dropped slightly to something between 92 and 93 degrees C, which is still way too much. Don't do it. I mean, the videos proves that the Shadow Rock 3 can do it, but it shouldn't do it. You should have a bit more overhead. It was fine for gaming. I during the benchmark for Shadow of the Tomb Raider, Metro Exodus, and Far Cry 6, we never exceeded like 70 degrees C, so for a gaming situation, it was fine. Of course, always the CPU, the fans were all running in 100% PVM, just to get like the max performance. However, I wouldn't do this. If you are doing a new build, don't do a Shadow Rock 3 combined with a 12900K. It works, but it just worked. That being said, I also did all of the game benchmarks and all of that kind of stuff. And my expectations were that it should be slightly below the Aurora build or the Nightlife build, which all had the exact same hardware. We had the 12900K and the 3070 Vision. However, the other two builds had their RAMs running in dual channel mode, whereas this does not. So what I was expecting is just slightly lower performance. It didn't turn out that way. See for yourself the numbers. Now, what doesn't make sense is that in absolutely every game, the average, the min and the minimum and the maximum FPS amount was higher, and then sometimes even a lot higher, and 1%, always freaking higher. The only exception to all of this was Far Cry 6, where we had 66 FPS on the 1% low and 72 on the Aurora build. So here, this one lost by 6 FPS, whereas on every other occasion, it won. And it shouldn't have won, it should lose. It doesn't make any sense. I doubt that the B660 board did something, I really doubt that. However, the only explanation I can come up with for right now is that I did a BIOS update on this main board due to the RAM issue. I didn't do it on the Asus Z690 ROG and every other keyword. Maybe there was something in the BIOS that changed how the 1200K behaves, which then led to big changes in performance. However, this shouldn't affect how the 3070 performs, and I am kind of expecting, I didn't check it now, but I'm expecting that considering we have a 12900K, the 3070 should be the bottleneck here, or the RAMs, but not the 12900K. I don't know for now, maybe I will do a video investigating this, I have no idea. These are the numbers that the benchmarks produced, I can't say anything more than what it did, it doesn't make any sense. But that's how it's going to be. Temperature-wise, don't do this. The Shader Rock 3 is not enough. I guess if you do stuff like undervolting, then yeah, probably. But like this, don't do it. This was a dumb idea. Good for testing, and especially because we will be doing another video with the Be Quiet just after this one, where I will be replacing all of the fans and hitting so many fans in there as I possibly can and just see how far we can push the case. So that's perfect that it is up against the upper limit, but for a normal use case, don't do this. This was a very bad idea. Look-wise, of course, I really like it. The white theme with a bit of black and silverish works pretty well. I'm quite happy how it turned out. But for the rest, don't do this. Another failed build. But okay, I hope you enjoyed it. But if you want to stick around, right after this one, we'll continue using the Be Quiet Silent Bass and then see what happens if we smash it full of really good fans. And I'm sure it will turn out just for you. If you want to keep watching, we have the Nightlight build. If you want to see a 1200K build that does not suck, it's pretty good. But other than that, thank you for watching and hope to see you in the next one. Bye-bye.